In this video, I want to talk about tempo. Tempo is the rate of speed, and it is marked in Italian language. So this lesson is coming from page 49 of your book. Tempo is one of the musical elements that definitely triggers or helps out the characters and the mood of the piece, because again, it is a very important element that tells you how fast or how slow to play your piece, okay? And the markings are usually placed at the beginning of a piece, okay? And markings, like I said, it is usually, not all the time, but usually in Italian language. The most common tempo marks are, there are tons of tempo marks. However, there are four that I want you to learn, okay? Andante, Italian language, meaning slowly walking tempo. Moderato, meaning moderately. So it's like in between slow and fast tempo. Allegretto means moderately fast. So it's a slightly faster than moderato. Then there's allegro, means fast. Allegro actually means happy. So when you see the tempo marks allegro, your mood has to be very happy mood, and you tend to play fast, okay? So the tempo marks will let you know how fast to play, and also the characters of the piece. And I want you to start recognizing, if you haven't done it, every piece they from this textbook, you have a metronome marking given to you. So if you don't have a metronome, there are tons of free metronome that you could download on your phone. And I want you to use it as a reference for the tempo, okay? So for example, the Yankee Doodle from page 49, it's set to 120. So if you set it 120, you'll feel like it's like 1, 2, 1, 4, like 1, 2, 3, 4, which is tends to be slightly faster. And as you see, we see the tempo marks for this piece, it says allegretto, okay? And another piece you see on page 49, down in the valley, this one has a tempo mark that says moderato, meaning moderately. So not too fast, not too slow. And here's a tempo marks given to you as well. So checking the tempo marks, the metronome marking, which is a very, very, very important device that you should utilize for all your practice, because these are a designated tempo for you to obtain, I mean to achieve, okay? But I don't want you to set at 120 from the beginning. Set it slow. Maybe start with 80, and once you get comfortable, you get 90, 100, you know, keep increasing the number. The higher number is faster tempo, okay? Lower number means slow. So here, I just want to show you these two pieces and how it works with different tempo marks. Yankee Doodle, like I said, has allegretto tempo marks. It's in 4/4 times, and we gotta play forte, means strong. We're gonna keep our middle C position. We just learned it from the other video, right? So here, make sure dumb, stay on middle C together. We take turn, don't forget, okay, to use it. So for up stems, it's all treble, middle C, play by right hand. There is also middle C on your bass staff. That middle C will be played by left hand. Okay, this is how it sounds for Yankee Doodles. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you three different tempo markings. Okay, I'm going to start with Andante, slow, walking tempo. Then I'm going to change to Moderato, then Allegretto. I'm going to even try up to Allegro and show you the differences. Okay, here we go. Andante, I'm going to set it about at 80-ish. 1, 2, 3.
Four.
moderato. Change the tempo again for allegretto like tempo. 120 is what you see given to you, so this is about 120. 1, 2, 3, 4. Changes really changes the mood and the spirit of the piece. That's why you have to always make sure you try to achieve the tempo marks given to you for all your pieces and get the right characteristics of the piece. Okay, Yankee Doodle needs to be happy sounding. So I want to try another tempo, which is allegro. Okay, because you gotta know these four standard tempo marks. Allegro is faster, obviously, than the allegretto. And maybe 130 or 140, a little faster, slightly a little faster than allegretto. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll try one more time. Another tempo which is actually way faster than allegretto, allegro, and it's used, and I added some harmony to it, so you heard something else than other than what you see on your piece. Just wanted to, for fun, okay? So just wanted to show you the differences between the tempo marks. Okay, so make sure you always check the tempo marks for every piece you work on. Down in the valley has a moderato marking. 3-4 times, so we need 3 beats per measure, right? Every time you have a 3-4 time signature, I want you to think of a little swinging. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. And this piece doesn't have to be that fast. So again, those of you who wants to try, you know, these two simple pieces with different tempo marks, please, okay, try to practice a couple times and just get comfortable with it. Down in the valley, in middle C position, okay, there's a one spot that you should probably practice separately. It's probably right here from the second line. Here is bar 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here we got in middle C position, both hand playing in different directions. So see, you start from 4, 3, 2, and we finish with the right thumb, 2, 3, there's a tie, 2, 3, another spot. This is where you gotta just one simple melody, but we get some harmony added by playing the left hand. Okay, it's right here and right here. So together, it sounds like this: 1, 2, 3, 1. It's a mountain song, so you could see you're on top of a mountain and down in the valley, having a little good fun time, okay, with tempo marking moderato. Okay, so I just wanted to introduce tempo marks, okay, very important element to music that you must always show in your pieces. Okay? Okay, this was from page 49. So here we're all done for this lesson.